So officially, this is the beginning of a hiking route just behind the city of Hong Kong, and we'll see how far behind it is. But we're not gonna go this way. That's just one way. What I want to do is take us a different direction through this naughty area. We're not supposed to, but this is like a workman's entrance or route. And this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna climb all these stairs first. Excuse my out of breathness when I eventually get out of breath. But we'll get back onto the other route later. Skip ahead if you're bored of steps. We're going to be a while. But it's a good warm up for the rest of the hiking route. Trees like this, or broken trees like this, are still from when a typhoon hit Hong Kong about 3 years ago. It's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We'll see how long this takes with just a straight walk. My God, I'm out of breath already. On these stairs, eh? But on the left, yes, that's the city, residential area of Kornhill. I need to catch my breath. But this is the end of Kornhill. These are the last buildings in this residential area. And then you can see the jungle starts. We're not gonna go that way either. But that is the hiking route if we took a left. Hi, Shadow. So this hiking route is convenient because it's behind my house and it's full of interesting things that we're going to stop and look at along the way. Some ruins, some things that Hong Kong people have built to make their hike more enjoyable. Let's go. And the steps haven't finished. Just remember that This is the unedited version, and there will be an edited version just showing the highlights if you don't want to immerse yourself with me on this particular hike for the next couple of hours. Immerse yourself, is that the right word? Entertain. Maybe entertain. Anyway, you're joining me, aren't you? I'll nod for you with the gimbal. Good. And we'll get to our second view after we've climbed these steps. I might add, I have to do this with no hands since I'm holding a gimbal and my keys in the other hand. It's glorious here. Here we go. I'm glad I can do slow pans. Catch my breath. But we're at the final leg of these steps. Right, we're basically at the top of this part of the peak. We're done. And we're going to go off, down. As you can see, again, these are from the typhoon that hit us a couple of years ago. Okay, now we are back in Tai Tam Country Park Quarry Bay Extension. I don't know who the madman is, but I'm not cycling. And for those who care about following the hiking routes, this is the way to Mount Parker Road. One of the things you'll notice while you're hiking in Hong Kong with me is that everything is almost paved. And it always makes me think, who paved these routes? Who laid down the wood barriers to prevent the soil from degrading under the footsteps of thousands of people? Right? How long are they going to stay here? So for as much as the hike is going to be tiring, and obviously some of you are out of breath just watching me. Think about the people who made these all those years ago. This part, of course, they couldn't be bothered filling this bit in. So we're going to follow this father and son for a bit. That was directly in front of us. Thank you. Okay. I'll stop in for a view in a minute. Two views. Here we go. Here's our first view of Hong Kong from the island. We can get higher. So, to the far left is Quarry Bay. And this is Taiku Place. And if we zoom all the way over there, we can see a red building, and that is called Megabox. And in front of Megabox is Kai Tak, what used to be Kai Tak Airport, which is now Kai Tak Cruise Terminal. That's on the Kowloon side of Hong Kong. And as we pan, you can see a road that's in front of the city that goes above the water. And that is Kwun Tong, Ngao Tao Kok. And then we have Yao Tong in the distance, that is. And then we've got a tiny little fishing village just center. Oh, let me just go up a bit. right there. We've been there before on the YouTube channel. Okay. As we keep going, in the distance is Lahas Park. That is a new structure though, that wedge looking tackle thing. I've never seen that before. That wasn't there last week. And there's the rest of it, just over here. And that's where we're going to go for the rest of this video. But having looking at that thing over there, whatever that is, I'm curious about that. I want to find out what that is. So maybe in another video very quickly, we'll have a look, okay? Let's make our way back down. Oh. Somebody wants the afternoon all to themselves. This will be the last view for a while. So enjoy. Let's go. Kind of a workout when you're by yourself, not with anybody else, and you go at your speed. I thought it was easy when I'm with someone else because I've got to wait for them. we don't want to go that way. And we don't want to go to the middle route either. So if you ever come to Hong Kong, you want to go left out of the three. And we get to another view. A little bit higher, and you can see a little bit more. In fact, in the distance, you can just make out the ICC on the Kowloon side of Hong Kong. We go above the ridge line, and there we can see Wan Po. That dome-shaped building on the absolute left, that's Mong Kok. And there's more, but I'll tell you what, we do get another close-up of that weird looking thing that I've never seen before. Just pan a little bit more to the left, to the right, sorry. There it is. Now it looks like it's been ferried in by a ship, because behind that you can see the makings of a bridge over the water, and that's exactly what's happening. They're building a bridge there near Lohas Park. Think of that green building, that building covered in green, that's Lohas Park Estate. And then further to the right of it is the beginnings of what's called TVB City. Okay, but anyway, we are gonna go hiking a little bit more, but we're out of the sun. And it's an even descent for the rest of this hike, so we should be able to power walk through this. And however fast I finish it, you'll probably take twice as long. See what some local Hong Kongers have built to make sure that no one slips off. Hong Kong people have done that. I don't know why as well, but it must be a cultural thing, but the men in Hong Kong, when they go hiking, if they want to listen to the radio, they make sure that you listen to it as well. And they've never heard of headphones. We're probably too high in the mountains. But they want to listen to their Chinese music or just the local radio without headphones. That was a hot beginning to the hike. Now it's really cool. I'm only wearing a tee and a special hiking shirt. Something used to be here. The metal barriers. The path has moved or something. Okay, 30 seconds of appreciation start now. If we zoom in, we're going to get close to Hang Fa Chun. Right dead center right now, that is a colonial building built by the British, which used to be a barracks. There's some over there as well. Just to the left center now. In fact, the white buildings in front of the water is Hang Fa Chun. And then this is the barracks, which is now a quarantine center for people with COVID. And way in the distance is a new housing estate that's being built behind Lohas Park. So now you can actually see the entirety of TVB City. And what is TVB City, you might ask? A lot of factory buildings and television studios there. Lohas Park again, for reference, and that weird floating structure. Who knows what that is? And in another YouTube video I did, see those white spots in that peak, right dead center? That's a graveyard. I'll put the link in the show notes if you want to check that out. But I do a little video blog over there to try and explore it. And there's a secluded beach that no one ever goes to. We'll have some people overtake us in a minute. They seem pretty fast walkers. At the moment, we're actually by a place called Chai Wan Ho, which is this place here. Hi. So it's just a quick power walk across the east side of Hong Kong Island. Right. What we're going to do is hit those rocks over there, and there's a path that takes us through over to there as well. Hi. If I'm showing you the floor, it's because I want you to see the terrain that my feet have to go through while I'm holding a gimbal, paying attention. Now, I did this route last week, that's why I'm doing it this week, but I couldn't figure out a way of getting down there, and this week that's where I want to go. But it's no big deal if I go the wrong way. You gotta go this way. Yeah, I'm not sure I'm gonna do that with the gimbal with one hand. But you see how there's ropes to help people? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go above and then go down. I know a route. In fact, I'll just take you the way I went last week. Seems a lot easier. Ugh. You're gonna have to excuse me. Excuse me. Gotta get it out. I hope you skipped over this. Scrubbed over it on the YouTube, just looking for highlights. Maybe the algorithm brought you there. But hey, that's reality. Hi. Isn't that nice? Okay, onward. But before we go, you notice how someone's built this over this stream. I love this kind of stuff. We don't get to just rumble through the water. And disrupt the flow of water. It's quaint. That's the word I'm thinking of. Quaint. here we have another view. It's just different perspectives of the same thing, actually. We saw this. We've done that one. What about an apple? We've done apples. Passion fruit? Yes. What about grapes? Yes. I know. Banana. Have we done a banana? No. Okay. How to defend yourself with a man holding a banana. I hope you realize if you're used to me from watching Periscope, I don't need the comments to entertain myself. I can just be a little bit mad and talk to myself for what has been 40 minutes now. Although, you know, let's rationalize it and let's just pretend I'm talking to you. Certainly don't remember this rock when I came here last time. Maybe I've gone the wrong way. In the distance is the famous Lion Rock. Doesn't really look like much of a lion over here, but does up close, I can assure you. Do you think this is easy so far? I think the beginning part was probably the most taxing, just to get it up. Otherwise, it's a cakewalk for the rest of it. Very little variation in altitude. Plus, I've made it harder because I wanted to climb the steps, not go along a nice gradual incline. Or decline, if you went the other way. Here we go. Look at this, some carefully placed stonework again. Isn't that nice of somebody to have done that? Now, if we zoom in, we're directly in front of Yao Tong. And then to the left is the fishing village. Okay, let's enjoy the rest of these carefully placed stones. Reminds me a little bit of Hobbiton from Lord of the Rings. I really don't remember this route though. Maybe this is what talking does, distract you, to think I was only here last week. You know what though? Even though you've seen some great views already, these aren't the best views to be had in Hong Kong. Much better views on different hiking trails. Hopefully we can get to them. Oh, we're getting closer to that weird thing. Let's zoom in. You can see the bridge much better now. That they're building, that is. And whatever that is that they're floating across. And in front of the bridge, in fact, I'm dead center. That's the barracks that is currently a COVID center. Much better view of it. There's the rest of the grounds. And then in the distance, where you see that red thing, that is like a 300 or 400 year old Tin Hau temple. And that is the village of Lei Tong. And I just recently did a live stream. If you want to check that out, I'll put it in the show notes. Okay, off we go. cold here. Oh, look at that. I tripped and the gimbal masked my fall. See, he had the radio playing. I really don't remember this place. I'm looking for a turnoff. And this isn't a complicated route. It should open up into something a lot more obvious. I keep mentioning it because I think it was pretty cool what I saw. But you're gonna miss out, aren't you, if I've gone the wrong way? Right, we're at the 50 minute mark, and for the first time I've switched hands. My right arm is dead, so now it's left-handed operation. But we can't tell Jonathan, so if he didn't say anything we wouldn't have known. Yeah, fair enough. I just wanted to just fill the void with something to say, okay? Fucking hell, everyone's so critical these days. Don't at me on Twitter. no wild boar on this journey. It's a shame. Would love to have gone face to face with an animal like that. Now here's something that I'll probably mention in many videos. Is this is this ribbon. When people do that in Hong Kong, it means that that is a verified route. Someone else has traversed it, and you can hike it also. Yeah, we've definitely gone a different way. I don't know how. I don't know how I achieved this this feat, but I've done it. See, there's another one. But usually those ribbons are reserved for when there is no obvious path, like what we've got here. But I don't understand why we're seeing them. Anyway, the upside of this is that we're going higher. The lower route had more curiosities. We've got about an hour's worth of light, maybe 70 minutes, but I don't think we need that much. We're good. And we've been walking for about an hour now. Well, I say we. Me. Here we are, another stream. Look at the careful arrangement of stones again. Someone did that. very grateful that they did as well. Okay, we've got an opening here. So we get another view. Hey, I don't want to see. Hey, could be back. There we go. Okay, well, the other route was more paved. Oh, oh, now my Apple Watch decides to record this walk. We've been walking for an hour, you. Yeah, and it's recorded the last 10 minutes of it. God damn it. Could have banked those calories. Now, how am I going to justify that fucking donut? Thanks, Apple. Did you not feel the heart rate? Everyone watching it did. At the beginning, when I went up those stairs, what were you doing? Goddamn watch. My God, this is getting really rough. I didn't expect this. Again, look at the rocks. Someone's laid these to make steps. Oh. And there's fewer people on this route. The video should have ended down here. That's where I should be. But I've mucked it up somehow. So we've got to finish this route. Hi. He didn't have his radio blaring. Usually the Apple Watch is really good. It seems to always turn on at the same place consistently. If I go for a power walk from my house to, say, one of the MTR stations, it always triggers just after the MTR station. I don't know why it didn't... ow. I don't know why it didn't do its job today. Well, this is new. We're now getting into Chai Wan territory. Basically the last stop on the island. Oh, you want another view? Check out this. Chai Wan. We've got a huge graveyard over there built into the side of the mountain side, or peak side, and there's still more there. We've got a recycling center, the harbor recycling center here. I'll zoom in for you. There you go. And you can see a Mercedes showroom on the waterfront. And then those tall buildings and everything after it is still Sai Wan, which has no MTR station, but still thousands of people live there. So they're, but they're still undeserving of a metro station for some reason. Oh, we're going down. We should be finished. If you're still with me, what's going to happen is that I'm going to bank this video, and then I'm going to fly my drone over pretty much the same route and get some great views from the drone's point of view, and then add in some infographics, and I'll just release them as and when, and try to make shorter videos. Ooh, okay, it's a bit dicey here. That's the plan. So you can just watch them unedited, or just watch the highlights, which will be more informative, whereas this one, I guess, is more experiential. Can you tell I haven't got all the panning quite right? Sorry. Slowing me down this. Another victim of 2018's hurricane or typhoon. Poor tree. But then, look where it was, amongst this rock. If I get good watch time, I'll do more of these unedited ones. You have tiny feet, Jonathan. It's the wide-angle lens, actually. I've got huge feet. I've got LeBron James size feet. I could have been a basketball player one time. Trust me, the wide-angle lens. Whoops. Right, let's have a change of pace. Let's hike down, shall we? I feel, if I go this way, I feel I'm in for trouble. And I'm actually walking around the side of Chai Wan towards the south. So, we're gonna take it down here. I'm gonna switch hands. I'm gonna make use of this rope. That way it looks more like an experience. Yeah. Although, that's pretty well frayed. Right, we can go that way, which I think I want to go, but something for next time is that. God, there's not much path, is there? How do I know I'm even going the right way? It's not so obvious now, is it? Again, it's only these steps that someone made. Bet you thought this was a dead end then, didn't you? I did. If you go back to the beginning of this video and see how well everything was signposted, and now it looks like we're just walking through someone's... Well, actually, there's lots of villages in Hong Kong that have been destroyed, removed, upended to make way for the big tower blocks. So it wouldn't surprise me if we're walking through the remnants of a village that was put on the side a long time ago. Why else would there be these stairs here? There's still some remnants of it behind my house. Mind your head. Here, this plant has got spikes on the side. So someone has recently come past and made sure to clip them off. Since it was coming out over. Thank you, kind person. And I'm wearing shorts. It's quite an incline here. I'm not sure if you can tell by the pressure of my feet squeezing on the floor. Whew. This is better to go up rather than down. There's a ribbon, so that's a good sign. I'm gonna make an assumption that this is the way to go. Oh, here it is, to the left. This is probably taking me back to the school, to that building I mentioned about 20 minutes ago. Probably. I don't know where I've gone. I'm lost. I think lost the gimbal there. I can see a path. I just don't know why it's taking me down and then up again. And back around, I'm actually doubling back on myself. Oh, it would be nice if I could bump into somebody. Oh, I know where I am now. So this tiny little road will take you all the way around to Stanley, which is basically on the south side of the island. And that's still the graveyard that I mentioned. Whole mountainside. It will be interesting to see where this comes out. And then next time, start the hike from this place. Oh, I see civilization to the right of me. Here we go. Made it. Somehow. Actually, I want to go that way. My spider sense was telling me to go this way. And I was right. So we've hit a road, but where does it go? It's so odd that there's a sitting out area here. too far east. Taxi. Taxi. Little joke for the New Yorkers. I probably need a bus like that. That'll get me back. Alright, time to put on my mask. Right, thank you for watching. This is the end of the video. And, see you in the next hike, I'm sure. Taxi!